Welcome to part 13 of Awesome Powder Coat's installation guide for the air-cooled Volkswagen engine. Now we're going to install the lower rear air deflector tin, these two parts right here. Again, these get thrown away a lot. They have a bunch of different names people call them. Bottom cylinder tin, rear cylinder tins, they're just small little parts. And again, they get taken off a lot by people that don't know what they are. So, this one sits up right here. Helps duct that air out the bottom. Takes two screws. Now, sometimes you can get mixed up. Because depending on what big pulley pin and small pulley pin you have, you might, the layer, the way the metal lays, you might be cover up this one, might not cover it, so you definitely want to check that. But in this case, these are both going to be installed now. Now on the other side, we have to install not only the tin that runs along the edge of the number two cylinder right here, but also now is the time to install the carburetor preheat tube, goes right here, also known as the stove pipe. You can see it's just the elbow, it's going to duct that warm air from the bottom of the cylinders and run a hose up to the air cleaner on the carburetor. So, in this case, is a little tricky because we've got two things to deal with here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start this back screw just to hold things in place. I know that's going to have to come back out when I fit the big pulley tin. This goes in here. Getting to the point where you're having to line a lot of different things up. Okay, I'm going to put that in. Now I'm going to go ahead and take this one back out. So I know I'm going to have to lay the big pulley pin over that. At this point, you have to decide how far you're going to take this. Are you going to install all the tin, the exhaust, the carburetor, the intake manifold, and then put the engine in the car? Or are you going to, what I like to do is put the engine in the car like this. Gives me a little more room to work for moving the engine back and forth. Once the engine's in, then I'll put the intake manifold, the exhaust, and the big pulley tin on. One thing to keep in mind, if you're running a single carburetor, center mounted, you probably want to at least put the intake manifold on right now because it's hard, awful hard to get on when it's in the car. If you're running dual carbs, you might as well leave the intake manifolds off because you're going to need the clearance. At this point, you've got a big decision to make. Do you keep going now, or do you put the engine in the car now?